But tonight is a milestone moment in Delbarton's history. This is the first concert performance of musical ensembles that take place during the school day, where students who are taking music for credit, and you can see middle school band, high school band, Scola, a number of ensembles and student performers that would not have been here had we not made that choice and created that opportunity for students to take music during the school day. So tonight is really important. You know how dedicated your sons are to making music, making art, and enriching our experience with their music and the passion they bring to it. And that combined with the historic nature of tonight makes me incredibly proud to be the head of this remarkable institution. So sit back, relax, enjoy the night, and enjoy a moment in Delbarton's history.
Thank you. Thank you. You heard much of the improvised solos on that. It's something that we focused on throughout the years, helping all of the musicians of the ensemble kind of find their voice with improvisation. So, on that tune you heard, Daniel on the guitar, Aaron on the other saxophone, Paul on the trumpet, and Matthew on the keyboard. And also want to give a big shout out to our drummer that just joined the ensemble this fall, playing the jazz ensemble for the first time. How about a big hand for Alex Clements on the drum? All right, we're going to continue with a piece from one of my favorite big band composers and arrangers, a great trumpeter who grew up in Chinette, worked in New York City, named Thad Jones. He worked with the County Bass Orchestra for 10 years and then came back to New York, started a band with a drummer named Al Lewis that started playing at the Village Vanguard in New York City in 1966 and still plays there every Monday night up to this day. So this is a great piece that he wrote that's been arranged, simplified a little bit from his version, but this is titled Big Dipper. And you're going to hear from Adi on the alto saxophone on this one, and Sebastian on keyboard, and Arthur at the piano as well. So hope you enjoy. Thank you. special guest, Mr. Lyman and Paul, and our third teacher, the operatic Chris. Our guitars, Daniel and Matthew. And not very often in your jazz ensemble's largest section is the piano section, but it is here. Our pianists, Matthew, Mark, Anthony, Arthur, Chris, and Sebastian. Keeping us all in line on the bass, we have Owen. And our drummers on the first tune, as I mentioned, Alex Clements. On the second tune, Alexander Echo. And on this third tune, Chris Holtby. So our last piece for tonight, and then we'll pass it on to all of the other great ensembles coming up. It is a tune titled Horace's Bag. As I referenced, our first tune was written by Horace Silver. This piece was written for Horace Silver. So we hope you enjoy it. You're going to hear from Nick on the baritone saxophone and Matthew on the guitar as well. Horace's Bag. Thanks so much. Thank you.
us this evening in the theater and also viewing our live streams online. This ensemble before you is our middle school band. We are so delighted that they are performing this evening. This ensemble is really made up of more than 50% beginners, meaning these kids just picked up an instrument 7 weeks ago. And it's really, again, pleasing to have you here. Culture Cello, the bass, and the guitars. Most of the guitar players have never played before. We are so happy that they are here in this ensemble. We're going to be performing. So we're going to be performing Allegro Presto from Symphony Number 2 by composer that I discovered recently named Joseph Bologne. Joseph Bologne was alive from 1745 to 1799, and he was born in West Indies, the son of a plantation owner, and his wife had a slave. Joseph's father enrolled him in a boarding school where he fenced and rode horses. He was a violinist and was recognized by his other famous musicians at the time in France. Joseph was one of the chief exponents of what we call symphony concert, which Mozart adopted. So we're pleased to perform now with the rest of Joseph. 1879, Johannes Brahms received an honorary doctorate from the University of Breslau, and in honor of this recognition, an occasion he wrote an academic festival overture. The humor of this piece is that the work contains four songs, all of which were college songs. The first performance of the piece was conducted by Brahms himself, and according to one report, the dignity of the occasion was interrupted as students burst spontaneously into the songs when they heard familiar songs being played. And now our high school band presents the Academic Festival Overture, which will conclude the instrumental portion of our concert. Thank you.
Thank you.
name. We've always had the name Schola Cantorum, the School of Singing for upper school group. Finding something evocative, something meaningful for this group. So if you have any ideas, I've challenged this group to come up with it too, because it's a different thing. Obviously, it is a school of singing, but I think it's nice for the group to have its own identity. So as a placeholder, we'll say middle school chorus or middle school choir for the time. This is a great group, and some of these boys are new to singing. Some of these boys have been singing a long time. I think we all know, though, at 7th and 8th grade, most of their instruments have changed. We've handed them a new instrument recently, so their voices have changed. Possibly some of their voices changed while they walked up on stage. We will see. So the traditional sound that you hear of an orchestra tuning, we have to do some of that too. You'll hear us do just a little bit of warm-up. We've been sitting down there and just to get the instruments back and our ears back, ready to do our thing. Both of these mics. We have a solo group coming up in a moment, so they're going to sing one of these pages of the song. I'm very excited for this evening in many ways, too. As Father Michael so beautifully said at the beginning, it's the start of something new. This is the beginning of an era. And we celebrated last year because it was the end of something that we were used to, but this is a really exciting time. And I've had conversations with many of you, but that investment of the school in the most precious thing they have is time. And to invest our time into the arts is such a huge statement. So I'm very grateful to the school, the administration, for having the faith and the trust and the support pouring to these boys to do this thing. So thanks again, very much. This concert, I think, is important as a snapshot. You'll only hear one song or two songs from groups, but it's nice to put that bookmark in our mind. It's like, that's what they sounded like in October. So that amazing transformation when you're hearing us in December and February and April and May, the growth that occurs will be outstanding. So thanks once again, and you're going to hear the song from the middle school chorus right now, Dover Beach. Thank you. style of music. You'll hear pieces throughout the year that are a cappella, meaning they're not accompanied by an instrument, but also it's a style. A cappella music is popularized by movies like Pitch Perfect or Glee. We get that idea of this collegiate group that does contemporary music, pop stuff, barbershop. It's just this whole gathering of songs in there. So we're going to sing one. I'm sure that you guys know. It was fun for me and made me feel super old when I told them there's this sitcom called Cheers. And none of them have heard it. It's like Seinfeld as far back as the memory goes. But you guys know Cheers. So enjoy where everybody knows your name. We're going to take just a moment to warm it up for a second, and then we'll be right with you. I tried to program this year is also a little bit uplifting, and I thought there's no better celebratory song of getting the gang back together than, like, be in a place where everybody knows your name. Be in this place of comfort. Return here. This is the first choral vocal concert we have in this space in a long, long time. So those uplifting things are really important, and I think that just hits the perfect note. Don't you want to be where everybody knows your name? So, without further ado, it's Scola Cantorum. If you resume seats, if you stand and join us. Come up, it's typical for us. You usually do it just for us, but you'll hear us faintly singing the alma mater from behind the curtain, maybe not even sure it's there. We do it more for us than we do as a concert piece. It's not a concert piece, but we didn't sing it tonight, and we're going to do it as our warm-up, so you'll hear the alma mater, maybe louder than you usually do. Feel free to clap.
Our noble alma mater.
for the CD.
Thank you. nobis domine tu, ora gloriam non, 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 nobis domine tu, ora gloriam non.
As a group that's sung together, I have quite, raise your hand if you are a returning member of Schola Cantorum. You've sung with this group before. There's a lot of them. Raise your hand if you're a new member singing with us for the first time. Welcome. It also makes learning music go pretty quickly, and us having traditional numbers, like, we sing the alma mater before we start. This last number that we're going to do for you, we do as a traditional closer for the past few years. Found a beautiful piece for men's voices. It sounds great, called Sing Your Way Home. And there's no better way to close the concert than that. If there are any choir alums, I know there are some that are not singing the group this year, come on up. You're going to sing Your Way Home with the group.
Thank you all very much. Thanks for coming out this evening. Comment and congratulations. soon when that becomes a thing again. But for tonight, thank you, thank you, thank you, and thank all of you for coming.